안녕하세요 여러분, 진짜 오랜만입니다. 오래 기다렸죠. 이 영상을 너무 늦게 올려서 죄송합니다. 솔직하게 말하면 우리 요즘에 좀 게을러졌습니다. 오늘은 다른 영상 스타일 해보겠습니다. 우리 한국에서는 아직 7개월 좀 남았는데 오늘은 관심이 있는 사람에게 서울에서 살면서 알게 된 것을 몇 가지를 이야기해 보겠습니다. 도움이 되시면 좋겠습니다. 우리 이 영상을 한국어로 진짜 하고 싶은데 아직도 자연스럽게 감정을 전달할 수 없어서 좀 힘들 것 같아요. 그러니까 영어로 넘어가 볼까요? Let's go!
Yeah, so like David said, we thought we'd just take this moment now that we've kind of just passed 5 months of living here to share kind of what we've been up to in this little break hiatus of vlogging, but also things that we've learned so far in our trip and things that we're looking forward to going forward. So yeah, it's been the rainy season here right now, so it lasts from anywhere from 2 to 6 weeks where it's like just really hot and rains a lot of the time. So that kind of has kept us from wanting to go out and like do a lot of things. So we didn't really feel like we had a ton to film, and thus the hiatus in filming. But yeah, we've just kind of been going to school, coming home, chilling, trying to go from air conditioned dry place to air conditioned dry place. And yeah, we're learning kind of how to still have fun, even though it's like not the nicest weather out. Definitely looking forward to the fall when it's a little bit cooler, drier. We can kind of get back out to exploring. But yeah, also I feel like so far we've been learning a lot since being here. So I don't know if you want to start.
Okay, so obviously a big one for us has just been cultural differences. Korea is really known for their fast moving culture. So they walk fast, they eat fast, they get delivered fast. Everything is about efficiency and doing it right, but doing it as quickly as possible. And there's so many great aspects of that we really enjoy. We love ordering food and getting it delivered within 20 minutes. We love just the convenience of everything, and the accessibility of everything here is amazing. But oftentimes we find it harder maybe to just escape, find a breath, walk somewhere out in nature without traffic noise or without just a lot of stimulants. So that's something we're learning, is trying to find those moments where we can still rest in the city. And yeah, it's just been an interesting experience to navigate life here amidst just the craziness of what Seoul brings. And like I said, there's so many good pros to this fast lifestyle, but we're also learning that we need to invest more time into really coming back down and giving ourselves rest that we need.
Yeah, I feel like that's a big culture shock, I guess, if you will, that we've kind of experienced. Super different from at home. I think another thing that I've been learning, noticing, experiencing lots of is, and I think so many people talk about this when they talk about Korea or culture shocks that they've experienced coming here, but is really the crazy high specific beauty standards that Korea has for guys and for girls. Obviously I noticed more standards that they have for girls. Yeah, it's just really shocking, I think, especially coming from North America, where I feel like, maybe I've said this before, but I feel like we have, or we are trying really hard to take steps forward in like body inclusivity and like diversity and celebrating uniqueness in people. And something that I've noticed a lot of here is how very streamlined the beauty standards are, and how strict they are, and how public they are. Like, they are so not ashamed to promote a very specific standard of beauty and way of looking. And I think that can be really hard for people that come from elsewhere, that have different, you know, expectations or different backgrounds or whatever. So that's definitely something that has been a learning curve. And also, I think that being said, I think there are things about Korean culture that we love, you know, like we love the convenience of it all and we love how hard people work and whatever, but there are also things that we are learning to be, you know, we respect the culture, but also we don't take them upon ourselves and feel that it is something that we need to assimilate into, I guess.
Totally.
And that is definitely one of them. I feel like if you're gonna come to Korea, I would highly encourage you to really prepare yourself for kind of the flood of promo that's gonna hit you about living a certain way and looking a certain way. And so that's something that we're really learning to hold on to, is the values that we have from home, just about, you know, celebrating uniqueness and diversity and inclusivity and all of that.
It's a good point.
Yeah.
And I think it's so important to say that our experience here has been so good.
Totally.
And but we want to speak from our experience. So we hope that this can just help you gain perspective of what life here is like a foreigner. And I think, honestly speaking, in the beginning, maybe we wanted too much to think like Korean people, because you're like, we need to acclimatize as fast as possible. But that doesn't necessarily mean giving up what you've learned from your own country's culture, what you personally believe in. So now we're kind of becoming more comfortable with finding that in between and being comfortable with our values and our beliefs, and being respectful of what Koreans think, but not necessarily always living exactly the same way. And I think that's a healthy place to be in. Absolutely.
Totally.
So it's an ongoing journey, but one that's been really valuable to continue growing in. Another one, I think, which is something a lot of people speak on, is just the identity of, or the concept of like a foreigner identity here, or in Korean, a waegukin, which I think obviously most people have an awareness that Asian culture is a little bit more homogenous, if that's the correct word. So just being prepared, if you do come here, you will always be a foreigner, no matter how good your Korean is, no matter how famous you are, no matter how good looking you are, whatever the case may be, you'll always be considered a foreigner. And for some people, that's great. I think there are a lot of advantages here to being a foreigner, and to just actively be seeking someone else's culture and from a lens of someone else.
Yeah.
So it's not necessarily a bad thing at all, but just it's a different dynamic. And sometimes it can be tiring, and sometimes it's amazing. Just being aware of that, and that's something that we're so comfortable in now and aware of, and was always aware of, but it is just a dynamic that you always kind of carry with you, and sometimes you get looks and sometimes you get stares, and it's just all part of the process of living here.
Yeah, I think like we come from Canada, where I do feel like Canada is a really diverse place. And I think, you know, lots of places are, like you go in Europe, you go to the States, whatever.
Right.
So we are very used to, I guess, like anyone could be Canadian. You know, you see anyone on the street, no matter their cultural background, like you just kind of assume, oh, they're Canadian. And so I think that is like a really big difference here, where if you see someone out and about who is, you know, clearly not Korean or of Korean descent,
or half Korean,
you know that they are not a Korean citizen, I guess. So you know that they're just likely visiting or working here or whatever, or maybe married to someone that lives here. And I think that's just the difference, is there's no like merging.
They're so welcoming and so kind. And I don't think we've really had a bad experience. I know that's not everyone's case, so I want to make sure we're speaking on just our experience, but the people here are so amazing and kind, but it is just a thing. You're a foreigner, you'll always be a foreigner. So if you wanted to come live here long-term, get ready to assume that identity of a waegukin.
Totally, and it's not a bad thing.
Absolutely not. It's just a thing.
Yeah, another thing that I think we're learning a lot is the challenges that come with, you know, finding community in a new place, in a place where, you know, the first language is not your first language, and where there's like such a high turnover of foreigners visiting, working, studying, whatever. I think we have been not surprised, but I guess like just challenged by the whole task of finding community and creating really meaningful relationships here. I think, you know, whether it be at church or at school, like there are so many foreigners here, but yeah, I think a lot of people assume that you as a foreigner are going to leave. You're not going to stick around for the long haul. So we've definitely noticed maybe a hesitancy to invest right away, or, you know, to connect on a deeper level right away. And I think that we come obviously from a very lucky and blessed place of having amazing community at home. We definitely were spoiled probably, and we know that that's not everyone's case, and there are people that struggle to find community even at home. But I think for us, we had such great friends and such great community at home that to come to a place where we moved here totally alone, we didn't know anyone. Our main connection is through school. And a lot of those people, surprisingly, at least in my class, and I don't know about yours, but you know, English actually isn't their first language either. And so there's just like a language barrier, there's a cultural barrier sometimes. But yeah, I don't know. I think that we didn't expect it to be as much of a challenge as it has been, which is neither a good thing nor a bad thing. It just is a learning process, and it's made us really grateful for the community that we have at home, and really hopeful for the community that we could still build in the next 8-9 months.
Absolutely.
But yeah, it's just been something unexpected, I think, for us that we're having to kind of journey through and navigate. I mean, great things will come out of it.
Yeah, I think. And I think also, like, if we really look inward, a lot of it has been on us, just making excuses. Maybe giving us kind of a way out because, oh, we're in a new place, so we'll get there eventually, we need to settle in more. So we've totally been lazy with that too, and it's something we're working on. But if you come to Seoul, or I think if you come to a lot of big foreign cities, loneliness is a huge thing for foreigners, and just because you're coming here with a lot of other foreigners doesn't mean you automatically make friends in an instant. You gotta really invest in others, you gotta work for it, you gotta find connections. And that's just something that we're still drawing in and working through, because it takes work. And the relationships we have made, that it's totally been worth it, but it just takes time and takes work to really find that community here. But maybe we wanna talk a little bit about just the process of learning Korean and how that's kind of shaped us and maybe even changed us a little bit. We came to Korea with a beginner's foundation. We've been self-studying for almost a year, I think, at that point. So I think we came in with enough to survive right off the top. And that's grown so much. I think both of us have grown so much in our ability to talk with Koreans or talk with fellow students who are studying the language, which has been so fun. We typically study about 4 hours a day in school. And then whatever spare time we have, we'll do self-study, and we'll try and make time to hang out with others just to continue to practice conversation. And through all of that, I think we've grown so much. I think one thing we've learned more recently is how school maybe isn't as important as just continuing to get exposure through everyday life in Korea. So we're really trying to maybe shift our perspective to not focusing as much on prioritizing school and grades and results, and more just how can we continue to step outside our comfort zone, go to new neighborhoods, go to new restaurants, try and converse with people on the street, just continue to grow that. Because something I've noticed is your Korean improvement doesn't always correlate with your confidence with speaking the language. So that's something I've had to work maybe even harder on than learning the language itself. It's just continue to grow in confidence and accept mistakes and learn from them. Because that's just the only way you really can improve on the language. So that's a cool journey we've been on. And I think we've noticed that maybe a little bit more recently, that's really starting to develop, but it took a really long time to start feeling confident in just speaking Korean in everyday life. But such a good, valuable skill to have, to be able to just bring what you can, even if it's not perfect, and have confidence in that. So
yeah, and I think like Koreans are so gracious, so when you try and, you know, speak their language. They obviously know that you're learning, not mm-hmm. perfect. But then there are situations where, you know, because of that like fast-paced culture, mm-hmm. they'll just default to speaking English to you because they
Absolutely.
Want to make it easier for you, but also for themselves. That like this is going to be the fastest way,
Absolutely.
which
is not bad.
Not bad at all. It's very thoughtful, actually. But in those moments, you're like, oh, I suck. Like,
yeah.
I was bad enough that they had to try and speak my language, and I'm in their country. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So I feel like just don't get discouraged
yeah.
by things
Absolutely.
Like that, because just everyone is learning.
Yeah.
And it takes so long to have that level of confidence to speak freely and comfortably in, like, you know, settings.
It comes with repetition. Absolutely. I think the message for others who are interested in coming to Korea is don't be overconfident in your Korean ability, but give yourself some credit if you have done some self-study. Speak with confidence. Koreans absolutely love when you try to converse with them in their language.
Yeah.
And no matter how far you feel like you may have still to go, I think if you can just approach every conversation with confidence, you'll just make so much more progress.
Mm-hmm. Totally.
I encourage you with that, and that's something we're still working on, but it's getting better and better.
Yeah,
so we're looking forward to the future.
Yeah, and I think going forward, we are really looking forward to what this next 8-9 months is gonna hold.
Still got time.
We are super expectant, and we're really anticipating lots of, you know, growth and learning and mm-hmm. improvement in a lot of ways, I think.
Absolutely.
Yeah, we're excited to continue to study hard, but like David said, not put all of the weight into just school, but into like really experiencing the daily life kind of moments.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and I think we're excited to get out again more, not
yeah.
just hole up in air-conditioned places, but be able to explore more of the city and even the Korea as a whole a little
yeah,
bit.
Yeah, absolutely.
Going
to Jeju soon, which will be really fun.
Yeah, we're looking forward to taking some trips, mm-hmm. spending time with some people coming to visit,
yeah.
and continuing to invest in the things that we came here to do, which
Absolutely.
Is learn and build connections and grow mm-hmm. as people. So
look out for more vlogs coming soon.
Yeah, we'll do a better job of that.
Absolutely. Thanks for bearing with us.
Yes.
Yeah.
네, 여러분, 오늘 영상을 보러 주셔서 감사합니다.
감사합니다.
질문이 있으면 댓글로 남겨주세요. 그리고 벌써 안 했으면 구독과 좋아요 버튼을 눌러주세요.
다음 영상에서 만나요.
다음에 봐요.
다음에 또 봐요.